Now, putting these anchovies in, what does this do?
Well, it just gives that nice sort of salty flavour.
Salty, yeah.
Oh, okay. And it goes particularly well with the garlic and particularly well with broccoli.
Still performing, this most honoured of American singers now devotes much of her time to teaching and to the Marilyn Horne Foundation, a non-profit organisation devoted to the art of the vocal recital. But her greatest joy is her granddaughter, Daisy.
You're off again.
Yeah, leaving in the morning
to see the baby. And to babysit her the whole weekend.
Really? Yeah. How gorgeous.
Yeah. Oh, it's my passion. A weekend is just the right amount of time, too,
then
for a grandma.
Back with the baby.
Yes, right. But, you know, she's my beloved. Let's drink to Daisy.
She's beautiful. Let's drink to your beautiful granddaughter.
Daisy Bernice.
Daisy Bernice.
Bernice was my mother's name, and I'm Marilyn Bernice, so this is very special.
This is cook's privilege. Was there a sense of sadness in your retirement from the operatic stage?
You know, there has to be some sadness somewhere, and I suppose that I will reflect upon it at some time, and then there will be kind of a bittersweet feeling about it. But I keep so active, and I have so much to do now with my teaching and with my foundation, and plus I still am singing. Some of my friends have asked me, you know, Jackie, don't you just feel terrible that you're not singing, you know, your great roles anymore and things like that. I said, guess what? I can't sing them anymore. So why would I feel just terrible? Because, I mean, I've had a great long go. I mean, I don't even know where to count except that, you know, my debut in opera was 46 years ago. So that's not so bad.
It's a very long time.
Most important qualities you think young opera singers need today?
I think you need almost blinders on to keep you on track. You have to keep concentrated on that. Then, you know, the other things that come in, like marriage and children, that makes it all the more difficult. Because in the end, those are the two things that have to count the most. I think you need to be honest. I think you need to be honest to yourself, with yourself, not kid yourself about things, you know. Be kind to your colleagues, but at times you've got to be absolutely adamant about what you want. Develop some kind of radar that weeds out people that are important to you and people who are not important to you, not listening to the wrong people, because there's a lot of wrong advice out there, be it career advice, be it vocal advice, whatever. Trying to, as I said, develop some good radar that you can zero in on the right people and not listen to the other people.
Would you make the same choice again?
Probably. I'm not going to say an absolute yes.
You astound me.
Well, it's because it's so damn hard. You know, it's a very hard life in spite of all of the wonderful things that come out of it, you know?
We'll have to wait for the next life for Marilyn Horne when she comes back as a soprano who's going to sing Charlie Hutton for us.
Maybe Daisy will
what
sing
a thrill
it.
That
Daisy
would be.
Now sings the Barney song.
Next week, fellow New Yorker and leading countertenor Derek Lee Reagan reveals that he's no slouch in the kitchen either. Aria and Pasta continues 8 o'clock next Friday.